Downtown between Brush Street and I-375. That's where we're located in the heart of Detroit at Ford Field, which first opened back in 2002. Today, we've got a Week 8 matchup on tap here between the Miami Dolphins and the Detroit Lions. Lurching closer toward the midway point of this NFL season, and we're underway on EA Sports. Here comes Khalif Raymond from his end zone. And they'll get him down right around the 25, actually the 26 officially, so a net gain of one there.
Let's
going to halt the action here. It's a timeout. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter.
Man ran a big nickel, man. I'm going to run all over this nigga.
One play has him up past the 40 already, and another first and 10. Once again, it's Swift.
Bring away the fat nigga that caught me, bro.
Yardage back at the 40. That play over before it got anywhere, thanks to Christian Wilkins. The Lions at 5-1 here in this early part of the season. They're in a real groove of late, winners of 5 of their last 6.
And I thought they played pretty well last week. Their execution, their discipline, their resilience, all on display in that victory.
And only a couple for him there as the tackle is made at the 42. This defense for the Dolphins. Pittsburgh.
It's a little bit about their performance last week, because the feeling was that it was a good, solid performance. They did what they needed to do to get the job done and get the win, but definitely a few lapses that they're looking to correct.
Now Eason.
Monday, you remember?
The Dolphins get there this time, and they bring him down. Christian Wilkins, able to record his 5th sack of the season.
It always helps for a visiting team to come in and set the tone on defense. In fact, when we talk with them from...
I swear, bro, these niggas do not be blocking.
Crowd quiet now early. See if their offense can take over and get some points on the board. They'll set a receiver in motion to the right. Eason gonna try and throw for it. And he'll let this one go deep for Chark. And he fires one that's intercepted. And the Dolphins are gonna take possession of the football as they force the turnover on the opening drive.
I really don't think you can fault the decision making here, because your offensive quarterback, they really had a big week last week.
Where?
Ready for them to go again.
Where? Where you seeing this?
But you definitely understand why they did what they did. That quarterback's been hot. You want to keep the ball in his hands and see if he can keep the magic going.
And he's got some space here. And he's finally taken down.
Keep your bed. She down.
Reaches the 14. It's a big play there for Miami. 46 yards. But welcome to the party. First carry.
I'll tell you, brother. You're being broken. Get wet. If he drops it, oh, he can't help you.
Hey, why you always throwing shade at me?
I ain't no shade at
you. You stay throwing shade at me, bro.
After the game, bro.
You see how she always throwing shade at me, bro? That jump's really sad, for real. Like,
I'm not gonna shade at you. I said, you tell Max everything. Come get wet. Max looks right at you. Anytime I talk to him, he
looks
right.
Cause he know I tell him what's right. He know I don't be telling him no good.
He looks right at up to his big brother.
Okay, he know I'm gonna feed him with Rod. I'm gonna tell him what I know. That nigga got a touchdown.
Why?
Fat touchdown. That's that nigga Mike. Got a touchdown.
May just change the thought process. Down, I think in the red zone, they might now consider going for it.
You need to run the ball again.
You stay around with your arm.
They'll try it now with Mostert. And he is in. Touchdown, Miami.
He's got our own.
No. Probably getting me, probably. You need to slip, but you got a bad touchdown.
Extra point up and good by Sanders, and it's now a 7-0 game. Morstead out now following the touchdown to kick. Right after the touchdown to extend their lead, now maybe opening the door a little bit there by allowing starting field position at the 40. Good starting field position for them as they come at the 41-yard line. They go play action with Eason. And that nearly a turnover, but it's incomplete. Oh, fortunate to retain possession there at second down. Pretty fortunate there, the interception that ended the last drive, and then boom, the first pass here almost picked on this drive.
Yeah, I think you can definitely call the question his decision making here in the first half.
Certainly not the best of decisions there. Lucky that one wasn't picked. On second down, Swift, and he'll make it only to the 43, a gain of 2.
Well, that's a good start to this drive on the defensive side of the ball.
And force the incompletion on first down, then you're able to shut down the running play on second.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised now. A little bit of pressure going at the quarterback in an expected passing situation.
Here's Eason to throw. Complete to right. And he gets this only to the 44-yard line. To keep the drive alive. They're going on fourth down. Here's Eason buying time to his left. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. So certainly an interesting call there to go for it. And it'll be a turnover on downs. So they give it up just on their side of midfield. And, yeah, I mean, a surprising decision there to go for that.
Must have a lot of confidence in his defense. Must feel like, hey, we're in great shape here because our defense can hold them.
And all the way in for a Miami touchdown. Raheem Mostert with touchdown number 2 in the game and now 11 on the year. Quickly to add on to their lead. Extra point up and good by Sanders. And that'll make the score 14-0. Morstead out now following the touchdown to kick. Here's Raymond bringing it out. And they will wrangle it down a couple yards shy of the 30. The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. They find themselves in a good size hole here, and a good size hole early on in this game as they come up on first down. Dancing to his left. Now he'll throw deep left side. Touchdown! Amon-Ra St. Brown. hitting double digits with his 10th touchdown of the season. And the Lions are able to strike quickly here as they are in for six.
Well, there's no doubt that this offense was in desperate need of a quick answer, and they got it. One play, and they're right back in this game.
Because you got the sense if they stalled out here and then another score on the other side to make it a three-score game, could have gotten ugly. The extra point splits the uprights, and that'll make our score 14-7. Here are the Lions now as they line up and kick this one away. Austin elects to bring this out of the end zone. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24. The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive. Well, partner, you know, coaches always say that every play is designed to score a touchdown. Sometimes that's not really true, but last drive, that was the case. One play to get into the end zone, and now they'll try to duplicate that success here.
And it's rare for those moments to happen. Incredible when they do. And you saw the celebration. Pure, unbridled joy after that one.
And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. 121 yards rushing for him so far as his terrific season continues here. So the ball moves into Lion territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 49-yard line. Flushed out right. Catch is made by Marquise Brown. And a six-yard gain gets him right around the 43. Line of scrimmage, the 43 on second and four. Now it's Rodgers. And he'll just get rid of it. Well, you and I, partner, we got the plum assignment this week. An unbeaten team against a one-loss team. Really not much separating these two entering play here today.
Not much at all. And I think for both coaches, they've looked at their team and said, guys, you got to know what you're getting into in this one, and you better be ready to go because you get to answer the big question of the day. Are we as good as we think we are? We're about to find out.
And he's got room, and he's out of bounds. Almost gets to the 10. 31 yards there and a first down.
Just about every coach we talk to says the crowd shouldn't affect us. That shouldn't be an issue. And then the next breath they talk about taking the crowd and taking them out of the game by picking up first downs and keeping them at bay. I think we just saw.
And he'll take this into the end zone for a Dolphins touchdown.
That's going crazy, man.
On his way to a monster game. Three first half touchdowns. And the Dolphins have taken
I ain't never seen somebody with so much backlash.
Extra point.
They're trying to be right, man. Oh, my God.
And it's now 21-7. Morstead out there following the touchdown kick. Here's Raymond bringing it out. And he had no room to run as he's tackled down inside the 20. The Detroit offense ready to begin their drive. Offense running back out here, and you remember last drive was pretty quick, about 10 seconds, Charles. One play, very long pass play that ended in the end zone. Oh, that's into a double team, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Channing Tindall. Oh, and I saw the pressure coming at him. That just looked problematic. Hit him as he threw it, and the interception ensued.
Let me pay homage to the man who stood in this spot before. He always talked about how much pressure is in the face of a guy. And can he step into a throw? And when you can't do that, oftentimes interceptions result.
He'll get this down to the 38. The run got four. Now they deal with a second and six. Now Rodgers. Towards the end zone for Brown. And that is caught. Touchdown, Miami. Marquise Brown, 38 yards. And the Dolphins take a three-touchdown lead. Extra point up and good by Sanders. And the lead now to 3 touchdowns and 21. Morstead, the punter, out to kick it off. Here's Raymond bringing it out.
And my niggas ain't blocking. His niggas blocking. Nice work on the return.
The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. And for this offense, Charles, you got to think kind of crucial here to put something together on this drive, because remember last time out, they threw the interception on the very first play.
And you can't afford to let this deep.
And that's caught inside the 35. Yeah, he'll be out just a yard or two shy of the 30. They give him a gain of 38.
There's no doubt in my mind that not many guys in this league have had the impact that he's had here in the first half of the season. He's been a big play guy from the word go and continues to be one with another one right there.
On first down, Jacob Eason. And for the third time here in this half, it's intercepted. Picked up by Xavier.
This is fucking crazy, bro. This nigga on the corner. I'm not even watching. 24-yard
line. Now, I'm not sure that the wheels, Charles, are coming completely off, but they're shaking a little bit. That's three interceptions, and now interceptions here on back-to-back drives.
And I think about what a Hall of Fame coach told me that he always told his teams, when a mistake happens, just move on to the next play. Let it go. Hard to do when you're throwing this many interceptions. That's exactly the attitude that has to be adopted.
A carry there for Mostert as he's able to work his way forward for a pretty good pickup on first down. Officially a gain of 5. Second down. Here's Mostert again. And some space here. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. Well, he's broken off some big-time runs here in this first half.
Man, let's just face it. When you go into a game, you think you've got the plays that are going to work, but when you actually get out there and they're starting to happen, your confidence rises, and he's running with terrific ability right now.
Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete.
I think he had to unload that one before he wanted to. He was right up in his grill. I think he was a dentist there without a license, don't you?
Just not enough time for the play to develop. Lucky it wasn't a fumble, really. That's caught by his big tight end, Mike Gesicki. And it's going to be another first down as they'll get him to the ground at the Lions 37. It's a pickup of 15 and a fresh set of downs. So the ball moves into Lion territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 37-yard line. Throwing now is Rodgers. And oh, a dangerous throw there. Nearly intercepted on the sideline, but it's incomplete. So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. To throw once more. That one caught by Tyreek Hill. And it's going to be another first down as they'll get him to the ground at the Lions 20-yard line. The middle they go with Mostert. And for one of the few times here today, this run's not going to go anywhere. Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down. If this defense wants to stay in this ballgame, they've got to start ending some drives. That helps.
And they have to look ahead at what they expect the offense to do. And right now with that lead, that's run the football.
And he will take it in for a Dolphins touchdown. Jeff Wilson taking it in from the 20. And the Dolphins continue to pull away here in this first half. Extra point up and good by Sanders. And a rout is on here in this first half. Morstead out now following the touchdown to kick. And it'll come out to the 25 as Raymond will elect not to bring it out. The Detroit offense ready to begin their drive. As the offense comes out here, Charles, remember they threw the interception last time out, but they were moving the football down the field. Looked like they were going to have a sustained drive that ended in points, but then the pick ensued.
And because of that, there's no way you can call the last drive a success.
And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. And the Dolphins are going to get the football here at their own 23. Well, that is interception number four for him, Charles. Four here in the first half alone, and they're already trailing by four possessions.
Makes me wonder, partner, do they just not have any confidence at all in the backup, or do they just have that much confidence in him? Able to throw four picks already, they're certainly hoping that he can turn things around and quickly.
And they nearly get this all the way to midfield. Mark him down at the 49. So one play, and they're already just shy of midfield. Once again, it's Mostert. And a good run here as he'll rumble all the way down to the 40-yard line. My goodness, 229 yards rushing for him as he has been tough to stop here this first half.
Now, this is an example of breaking down a defense because on a lot of these runs, he's getting past the point of attack, and guess what he's doing? Forcing the secondary guys to have to make a lot of tackles.
On first and 10, here's Rodgers. Getting this out to the flat, Mostert. And he's going to be taken down at the 28-yard line. Now on first down. And that is incomplete. Down to 15 seconds now.
Well, what looked like a march to the end zone has hit a momentary roadblock with that incompletion. No need to panic. They just got to come up with a high percentage play call and see if they can get their offense back on track.
So now they'll come up on second and 10 once again from the 28. Rodgers now to throw. Throw left side is complete on the diving effort.
And that's a lead that excites a team as they head into the half. Good way to finish things off.
Yeah, able to extend that lead, and you always say it, that can totally change the complexion of half number two.
Yeah, it changes your morale, changes your outlook, but even before that, let's see if they decide to kind of squib kick or what they're going to do on the kickoff, because you don't want to give up a big play right before the half ends.
Good point. So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away. Here's Raymond bringing it out. And a decent return out to the 27-yard line.
You tell me, bro.
What you said? What you said? I'm drunk.
The Lions
I said I'm drunk.
Ready to kick
I said I'm drunk. I said you had 5 minutes.
I did not. I didn't say that.
Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. Flush to his right. And he'll let this one go deep for Chark. And now here is another interception.
And it is not long. It is right
final play of this first half. So we've reached halftime here.
And it's quickly turning into a final round
as we head down to Orlando. That's where we find our man, Jonathan Coachman, in our EA Sports halftime report. Coach! The Dolphins in front, and they'll be in possession of the football first as the second half gets started. And it'll come out to the 25. Austin not going to try and return it. The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive. Well, this offense, this team, they are rolling right now, Charles. They've scored on three straight possessions. You look at the scoreboard, and they pretty much right now got this thing under cruise control.
Yeah, and this is the time of game where you and I have to be prepared, right? Is this
kind
of
one?
Fight for it, and this is caught. What a catch. It's a big play there for Miami. 54 yards. Typically with catches like that, we talk about the height of the wide receiver, but he's one of the shorter receivers in the NFL.
And it doesn't seem to matter, does it? Put the tape measure away. How about some of these guys under 6 feet tall? Antonio Brown, T.Y. Hilton, and Super Bowl 53 MVP, Julian Edelman.
On play action, it's Rodgers. On the throw, led him too much that time. It's incomplete.
Quarterbacking 101. Never force the ball into double coverage.
On second down, Mostert.
And
he's going to push his way down about the 12. They'll come to the line, needing only 2 yards to gain the first two.
Yeah, the Dolphins.
It's the same round.
They'll try and
so it's the same operation.
It's the same round, bro.
Power is it. Power is on. And the area is on. That's how he beat me in that jet week. I just start trying. They start.
I'm just playing to find a defense for a commit, man.
On fourth down, they'll try and run for it.
It's like you shoot the guy. It's about himself. It was even worse. He had even ghosted.
Give him credit. They knew what they wanted to do. Here's Mostert. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line.
Like, swear how he's on the wall.
Here's second and goal.
Now
Rodgers. And he's got his tight end Gesicki in the end zone. Touchdown, Dolphins. A 9-yard touchdown there. And the Dolphins take the opening kickoff of the ball. Drive right down the field. It's still their lead. Extra point up and good by Sanders. And the lead grows even larger here in the third quarter. Morstead out now following the touchdown to kick. No run back here for Raymond. This will be a touchback. Detroit offense ready to begin their drive. They're looking to make a bit of a 180. They are sputtering right now.
And frankly, I think it's time to call your playmakers together and say, all right, guys, we're going to lean on you through this patch. We need you to get us back on track and get us going in the right direction. So you're calling plays geared to them. Not necessarily that you look at your plays, oh, this hurts the defense. I want the ball in the hands of X, Y, and Z and see if we can move forward.
So don't get too cute. Go to the playmakers. So second and 10 now here in the third quarter from Detroit. Eason going to throw it out of the shotgun. And he'll let this one go deep for Chark. And my goodness, another interception. Picked up by Xavien Howard. And the Dolphins are in great shape here as they take over at their 46-yard line. Yet another interception, and I just had to double-check my math. But it is now 8 between last week and this week.
Well, I just used the calculator. I didn't worry about double-checking it. But the thing that always throws me when you see quarterbacks in this type of a bad spot, they're trying to figure out what they can do to change it, and sometimes they try too hard. And they never get out of it. And that's where he is right now. He's just locked in a really bad way.
The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive. They start near midfield following the interception as they begin first and 10. So after the INT, it's Rodgers. They'll swing this out to Mostert. And he'll be tackled on the other side of midfield at the 46-yard line. Throwing again on second down, Rodgers. He'll get this complete to Calvin Austin. And he's going to get this one down to the edge of the red zone. A first down there on a pickup of 25. Into the red zone, it's Rodgers. Austin is there and brings in another one. And he's brought down inside the 20 at the 18-yard line. Looking to throw again on second down. Rodgers. And that'll be off the mark, too far out in front, and it's incomplete.
Let's give this defense some credit now. They let the guys get downfield. But when push came to shove, they stood their ground. Now they'll likely force a field goal attempt.
Here's Rodgers. Nowhere to turn this time, and he goes down. Sacked back at the 29. Rodgers to throw for it on fourth. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. The Dolphins can't convert on fourth down, and the Lions will take over. So they've converted their first two fourth down attempts. Not there. Now they're 2 for 3.
You think maybe the offense coordinator expended a little capital on that one? You know, when you're 2 for 2, you can lobby for that third one, right? Didn't get it there. Maybe now the head coach might not be so eager to go for it as we go forward.
Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. And he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. Final minute now in the third quarter. To try again after the sack. Eason. Oh, hit as he throws there, incomplete.
But they certainly aren't letting up today, partner, because they've forced big turnovers already, and it's been incredibly tough for them to get yards against, let alone put points up on the board.
And now here is another interception. Picked up by Xavier Howard. And he will bring it back. It's a pick six and a Dolphins touchdown. And Charles, for this offense, those interception woes they kind of had in the first half have now followed them into the second half. And for this defense, they take advantage, turn that into a pick six.
And that defense is in a spot now where they're thinking about ways to close this game out. And as confidently as they've been playing, I expect them to do exactly that.
Extra point up and good by Sanders, and the lead grows even larger here in the third quarter. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six, and now the kick is away. Here's Raymond bringing it out. They had tackled at the 21-yard line, so a net negative there of 4 yards. Offense ready to kick off their next drive.
Well, we're still in the third quarter, so there's some time to kind of clean this up and make it look more respectable now. A win, that's probably gone out the window, Charles, but I don't know. Do you look at this as a time to just improve and maybe start to look towards the future?
I think you have to find something to play for, something to grasp onto until the clock runs out. But Brandon, we've been around this game a long time. This is an outlier. You don't get many blowouts like this, no matter how the game looks on paper going in. This one has turned out to be everyone's worst nightmare realized.
His second catch, and this one not nearly as electrifying as his first. And it'll bring up third down now.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he could get a good head of steam going.
The offense on third down, 0 for 3 to this point. They could use a conversion. This will be third and 6. They'll roll him out right. He's got a man complete. And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 40. 33 yards that time. Defensively, I know they have the comfortable lead here in the fourth, but they do not want to give up big plays like that.
They want to finish strong. So oftentimes in this situation, you tighten up underneath in your coverage and you bring your safeties back. They can.
And my goodness, another interception. Picked off by Channing Tindall. And the Dolphins are going to have the football here at their own 35-yard line. Another great play defensively. They've been sharp on both sides of the ball, Charles. But that interception means that this defense can very well keep them down to single digits on the scoreboard in this game.
And that's certainly something to smile about, isn't it, partner, if you're on defense? Because your goal every game is to make a shutout. But you and I both know that's pretty unrealistic. But to hold a team below double figures in a game, in an NFL game, that's certainly something to take pride in.
Trying for Brown, and it's intercepted. Picked by Jeff Okuda. And the Lions have possession of the football. Now they get a fourth quarter pick. A little something to hang their hat on, I guess.
Okay, so let's face it, though. Who's happy about this play? Fantasy guys, right?
Yeah.
The analytics will tell you one thing or another. That's a bad play on one hand, a good play on the other, but it's all about the fantasy points here.
Yeah, because this ball game is over. Oh, he dropped it. And that's pretty indicative of the way this one's gone. So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. And they'll bring the big tight end across the formation left. To throw on second and 10, Eason. Escaping the pressure right. Oh, that'll be incomplete. Oh, he took a shot as he let that go. And it's going to bring up a third down.
They lead big, and a major part of that has been how they've taken their play to a whole new level this second half. No points allowed since the break, and you can add another incompletion to the total number that they forced in this runaway contest.
Throwing is Eason. A diving effort, but only right at the line of scrimmage. First and 10, Eason. Looking for Wright, and he finds him. And they will eventually get him down, but he's inside the 5 all the way to the 3. Swift. Is in for a Lions touchdown. Well, CD, they just haven't had a whole lot to cheer about or really grasp onto in this game. They've been dominated, but at least they get a late touchdown here, something positive to put on film for tomorrow's session.
Yeah, they're still trying to execute, trying to get some positives on their board and ledger sheet and keep this from being a total loss. Give them credit. They're going down fighting.
The Lions now as they line up and kick this one away. And it'll come out to the 25. Austin not going to try and return it. The Dolphins at the line, ready for their next drive. And this team continues to stake its claim as Super Bowl favorites. They are now eyeing an 8th straight win as they begin this drive here in the fourth quarter. They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. Oh, he was hit as he threw it there, and that one winds up incomplete. But at this juncture, CD, you normally see teams pack in the passing game. They've got the huge lead. Not them, though. They're still taking their shots.
I remember reading in past history, there was a college football coach in the Hall of Fame whose nickname was Close the Gates of Mercy. But he wasn't really big on that. He was big on go ahead and scoring. He's kind of reincarnated right here. We're watching it in front of us.
Rodgers will try again on second down. Over the middle, he's got Gesicki, the big 6'5 tight end. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Throwing is Rodgers. And this is caught. It's Brown. And he'll have it past midfield almost to the 40 before being taken down. So the ball moves into Lion territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 41. To throw is Rodgers. He'll get this to his tight end, Gesicki. And they're going to get this down to about the 37.
Oh, it's time to give a little credit there to the defense. They played that very well because it was a drag route. And he ran a little shallower than normal as he worked straight across the field. He was hoping he'd get lost behind the defensive line. But once he made the catch, nowhere to turn upfield and gain any yardage.
A handoff running left is Mostert. And a pretty good run as he'll get this down close to a first at the Lions 32. On third down, here comes Mostert. And he'll be taken down, but he does have first down yardage. A strong 8 yards will keep this drive rolling.
And carries like that, that's how they're going to continue to salt this thing away here, Charles, in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, how about that? A new set of downs. Clock continues to move. No better way to close out a game than to tap those mastodons you have up front and say, guys, keep pounding them. Let's keep the ball, keep their offense on the sidelines, and let's close this one out.
8 yards on the pickup, and now they'll have some options on second and short.
Not even telling him. Osberg got like 10
on the road. Try and throw on third down. Being chased down left.
He's
so unable to
connect. If he
had caught it, he would have pooped out. Their passing attack, even though that one was incomplete, has been really sharp in this one. It's resulted in a lot of touchdowns. And it looks like they're not going to stop throwing the football until the very end of this one.
Well, that will certainly make everyone involved on offense pretty happy because that gives them all a chance to pad their stats. As far as the actual need, you and I both know they can just run this.
You see what I'm saying, bro? This is coming all game.
The Dolphins can't convert on fourth down, and the Lions will take over. So we were looking at each other up here in the booth when they went for that, saying, oh, wow, talk about trying to add insult to injury.
Some teams are just like that. You know, some philosophies, some coaches are like, look, when I got a chance to put some more points on the board, I don't care what the situation, I'm going to do it. And they're also the same coaches, as a general rule, that if someone does it to them, you won't hear people protest out of them. That's just who they are. Even with such a big lead late, the effort hasn't lapsed one bit. If the offense wants to score some points in this one, they're going to have to earn it. These guys are not giving up anything.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. Play action. It's Eason. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. And now here is another interception. And the Dolphins are going to take possession of the football.
Yet another mistake after the interception there. And gosh, you look up at the scoreboard, they just got to be thinking this one cannot get over fast enough.
It certainly can't. And also what happens when you get this big of a deficit, you're supposed to make all the right throws, right? You're supposed to try and obviously get the ball to your own guys. But being down this big, you also take even more chances. And in this situation, that hasn't paid off for them at all.
On the other sideline, jubilation and laughter. So from inside the 20, here's first and 10 at the 18. Rodgers looking to throw. This will be caught just inside the 10. And the Dolphins are going to have a first and goal as he'll be taken down at the 7-yard line. There's Rodgers to throw. And he's brought down right at the 5-yard line. Give him 2 on the play. Give him a couple on the scramble. It's second down. Fans usually love to see scoring, and there was no shortage of it today. What a dominant showing from an offense that was truly playing at an elite level in this contest.
Partner, this game was over.
Bobby Pro.